Hello, George. Are you awake?
I remember ringing Boy George in New York, and he was still in bed, and I said, get on the Concorde and
all right, don't go out.
Get over. And he did.
Daisy.
You want to do that, yeah? Okay. I'm a papa. I'm a pop star.
In our world of plenty, Christmas time.
Joe Cocker.
Joe Cockup.
You Irish munchkin.
Simon.
Hey, walk this way.
Don't try to crash the room in.
Everybody's quite good. Bloody hell.
Enough factors.
My neck's Ralph, or is it Paul Young neck?
No, it was Paul Young's boss.
Al's neck.
No, it wasn't Al. That was Al.
Who was that?
George Michael.
God, it's Benny Camp. But then he is.
Look at your mess.
Don't you see any harmonies?
Not on that bit. There's another bit here that I'd like you to do as well, though.
After that,
I suppose there is a moral reason for buying it, you know.
Any other good reason it might make number one for Christmas?
Any other good reason? Well, it just means it'll stuff all these really trashy bands getting to number one. I mean, it'd be nice to have a record that sort of had some kind of sort of social significance, you know. I would say it was more socially political than political. I think that's more important, you know. Caring about other people is really important. You know, and there isn't really that much charity in the world when you think about it. You know, and I know there are a lot of other people who are pop stars who do a lot more work for charity. You know, I don't want to stand here saying, oh, we're so wonderful. But if you do have an opportunity and you can use your position to influence people to sort of spend money on something like this, I think it is healthy, you know. Because, I mean, you know, we're so indulgent, aren't we, really?
Is that it? This is the number one, this one.
I got woken up at about 4 in the morning by Bob Geldof. And I didn't really know Bob. I mean, I knew of him through Boomtown Rats, and we sort of met at parties, but I didn't really know him, you know, well enough to be calling me up at 4 o'clock in the morning. But it was such a kind of shock to hear this kind of mad Irish voice screaming at me down the phone, saying, you know, you've got to come back.